ChatGPT is incredibly trendy these days. I know that ChatGPT is being used in many fields. I'm also a big fan of ChatGPT and I'm using it very diversely. Anyway, I made a ChatGPT client for Arduino to easily use ChatGPT in the Arduino environment. Currently, only the simplest chat is possible, so it seems that it needs to be updated continuously. Since this uses the API provided by OpenAI, your own API key is required. This is the main page of OpenAI. Looking at the prices here, it is charging 0.2 cents per 1k tokens. They usually charge it on a per token basis rather than per API call. Looking here, 1k tokens are about 750 words. Considering that you can make about one page of your blog for 0.2 cents, I don't think it's that expensive. When I first started, I got an $18 credit. As you can see, I've made about 100 requests so far, and I've been charged about 3 cents. You can use it cheaper than you think. In order to call the API, an API key must be issued first. Please create your own key here. Copy this key, we will use it later. Okay, all looks good. Now let's open the Arduino IDE. Search for ChatGPT in Library Manager. Download this. Since all data returned from OpenAI's API is JSON type, Arduino JSON was used to extract the necessary data, so please install the Arduino JSON library together. ChatGPT client for Arduino is installed. Among the examples of ChatGPT, I use ESP32, so I will use the ESP Wi-Fi client secure example. Update your Wi-Fi credentials to access your network. Paste the API key you created earlier here. This is all ready to use. API calls use the HTTPS protocol, so CA certificates are required. When calling simple message, the return data is string type content. This is an extract of only the answer part from the returned data. If you call for message, you can see all the data returned from the API. If you need a specific part of this data, you can extract it using JSON parsing. Now let's build and test this. As you can see, I asked a question to ChatGPT and got an answer. It looks good. I will have to refer to this for my next trip to San Diego. I really like the travel plan he presented. If you look here, you can see the JSON string. Currently, the structure returned by OpenAI's API is as follows. If you need a specific part of your program, you can parse this JSON directory using the full message function. I thought about an embedded system going with ChatGPT. We generally connect many sensors to the MCU and use them, and it sends the data obtained from these sensors to the user. Let's say we have a temperature sensor like a DHT11. This will give us the current temperature and humidity information. That's great, but it's just numerical information. What if we could use ChatGPT to get more information? For example, The current temperature is 30 degrees and the humidity is 50%. Can you tell me what closest to where you can ask like that? Then ChatGPT has the temperature and humidity information and can provide us with good information about it. This will allow users to provide more meaningful data beyond just numbers. Let's test what data we can actually receive from it. My question is here, what kind of clothes should I wear when the temperature is 30 degrees and the humidity is 50%? This is what I'm going to ask ChatGPT. Let's assume that we have created a string like this. Wi-Fi is connected. It's asking now. It gives me very detailed information. It is hot and humid, so linen and cotton clothes are recommended. And it is mentioned not to forget a hat and sunglasses. That's great. As another example, let's assume that a lot of data comes in from a specific sensor. It can be used for data analysis using ChatGPT. I prepared 100 random datasets, analyzing the value received from the sensors and delivering the result to the user can provide a new perspective on the data results. The dataset I prepared doesn't seem to have any singularity. I was only able to get information about mean, max, average, and standard deviation. But still, it's good. It can be a good data analysis tool if you ask for a little more detail. If I get a chance, I'll try to test ChatGPT using a different dataset and more detailed questions. The last use case is a way to use it directly. Text input is required to ask any questions to ChatGPT. Also, API calls can only be made if you are connected to the internet. The Wi-Fi connection must be dynamic to do so because we cannot build it every time when we use it in different places. I have the perfect device for this. This is my device called the ESP32 Berry. You can get the information on this from my GitHub page. I plan to sell this device, but I still have a lot to do. I will try to keep updating. If you have a Wi-Fi connection, you can ask any question you want through the ChatGPT app. Actually, this is nothing. We always have our mobile phones with us and we can easily access ChatGPT from our phones through a web browser. The reason I tried this is to show that it can be used in this environment. It would be nice if you could watch it for fun. ChatGPT is really great for usability. As a good tutor, it can teach us to code, analyze data, and give us the answers we need. If there is a chance, I'd like to continue to provide support for easy connection with ChatGPT in an embedded environment. I look forward to interesting projects using ChatGPT with MCU. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.